Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Omanis and today I will review the 5th studio album by the rock band King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. This is the last time I ever say that name because I'm done with this band. You know, I'm not like I don't hate this band, but you know, it's just very tiresome for me to listen to this band because you know, all of their songs sound the same to me. It just all blends in. It's all like white noise to me, essentially. So I don't care, to be honest. I'm not gonna give this album a low rating just because I'm done with this band, but you know, I'm gonna say this, you know, basically what I just said, you know, I'm just done with them because I don't hear anything new from them. It's all like really fuzzy, hard rock, heavy metal, trash, psychedelic music, you know. King Gizzard is all over the fucking place. I can't really describe these guys. We have fucking 10 tracks on there. It's a pretty consistent album, I think. All tracks written by Stu McKenzie, except Hot Water by Joey Walker and McKenzie, so Stu McKenzie doing all the work, of course, as usual, production, songwriting, fucking production work or fucking instruments and shit. He does everything, essentially. Can't say I care that much, but, you know, it is what it is. There's this really weird thing with the fucking first four songs where I'm in your mind, you know, that's the I'm in your mind first, that's how the album is called. Or is it, yeah, I'm in your mind first. That is the fucking title of the album. So we have I'm in your mind, which is a pretty standard opening track, nothing really special, to be honest. Then we have I'm not in your mind, which is essentially kind of an anti-reaction to that last song. Just an anti, kind of like an opposite kind of track, whereas I'm in your mind is kind of more conventional and a bit more, you know, just regular, I think, just standard. Whereas I'm not in your mind is a bit more bleak, a bit more, you know, still in that theme of the first track, but this one is a bit more unconventional. It's a bit more, you know, less commercial, less sketchy in a way. It's just kind of like more unconventional, like I said. Now I have this weird song in the middle, Cellophane, and I'm not even sure if that's a thing. I know Cellophone, I think. Cellophone. I'm not sure if Cellophane is a thing, that they might have made it up because it's fucking King Gizzard. So this song was kind of pretty, I think. I do think that the song had kind of some merit to it. I do think that this track was kind of interesting, to be honest. But to be honest, this whole like early section is really weird because then there's the title track I'm in your mind first, which is the most all over the place hectic song of the album. It's arguably one of my favorites because it's, you know, very just kind of weird, to be honest. It's honestly just kind of an odd track, to be honest. I think that this track is really just all over the place, like I said, just very like fuzzy, just very like just regular rock, heavy metal, thrash metal, some prog in there. It has essentially everything that you want from the band, which, you know, for me personally, they're just kind of too hectic for me. They're just kind of all over the place, but I did like it. I thought it was good, but you know, eh. Well, it's still eh, I think, but the band essentially. But I do think that this is my favorite song of the album, arguably, because it just has a little bit of everything. So I think it's quite a nice change of pace, or just kind of a nice varied song in a way. A lot of variety, so there you go. Empty. Yeah, I think after this point the album just kind of sounded one note to me. It just kind of went on forever and I just didn't really care anymore. So Empty is essentially, you know, lives up to the title, I think. Hot Water, I did like it. It's a bit more interesting, but overall the band still sounded relatively the same to me, and overall didn't really left an, you know, everlasting impact on me, especially, you know, who else? Joey Walker also wrote the song, so the songwriting is also weaker because Stu McKenzie is just an oiled machine, and anyone who gets in his way just kind of makes them weaker, just slows them down. So that's essentially what the song is, for me at least. Am I in Heaven is a really long-lasting, really a track that goes on forever. It's essentially their attempt, I think, at a Stairway to Heaven, because it's also in that vein and it has Heaven in the name, so why not? I'm just like ass-pulling right now at this point, like I always do, so like who fucking cares? If I have to name at least favorite of the album, it would probably be Am I in Heaven, because it just fucking goes on forever. I don't think it sounds bad, but the band, you know, they just sound so by the number, so, you know, just very drab, just very fuzzy, just overly fuzz. I think that's essentially what they are, just fuzz, true and true. I don't hate this song, but I think it just goes on forever, and it just, like, there's no fucking ending to it. It's just so tiresome for me. I'm not gonna go, if you think this review is getting negative, I'm gonna go up again, because this band is unpredictable as hell, inconsistent as shit, or well, actually very consistent. They dropped 5 records in 2017. They dropped so many records in that year, they took a whole year off in 2018. Fucking hell. King Gizzard are taking a year off. Wow. That's some fucking magic right there. So then we get Slow Jam 1, which was alright, I think. I do think that the sequel is a bit better, actually way better in my opinion. But this was a nice kind of opening track. I do think that this track was overall, you know, a very nice introduction to the Slow Jam, sequel in a way, the Slow Jam series, the mini-series, I suppose. Nice introduction point, but not anything special, I think. I do think that Satan's speed up was better. It's just a bit more ferocious. It's a bit more fast-paced. I do actually really like the organ or the kind of keyboards on the sound. I do think that was pretty interesting. So if I do have to... Yeah, this is probably my favorite track of the album, because it has some really interesting production. It didn't go on for a long time, and it was just an overall very pleasant song to listen to. So I might even return to Satan Speed Up, but this was really enjoyable. And then we get Her and I, Slow Jam 2. So this is part 2, and I think that this track, you know, really finishes off Slow Jam 1. And I do think that the band ends on a pretty good note there. Overall, this was a good song, pretty diverse. This is the only epic, this is the epic of the album. Tool, take fucking notes. So this was overall a very just epic track, I think. It is really long, but it didn't like go on forever. It has a little bit of Satan speed up in there, as in the nice keyboards. It did continue from Slow Jam 1, kind of continued up until that point, and just kind of built on that strength of Slow Jam 1 and made it better. So this was overall very just enjoyable ending to this album, to I'm In Your Mind First, which is, I think, their most acclaimed album. So I'm gonna say this, King Gizzard is a good band. King Gizzard is aight, they are acclaimed for a reason. They essentially have every genre in there, you know, they're all the genres that I like. Go to like Rage Your Music, look at their genres, and I like all the genres, except for punk at the end, I believe. There was some kind of punk label to them which you don't like, but I mean, besides that, you know, I do like some punk. Besides that, all those genres that they have are great. I do love all those genres that they have. But I'm tired of hearing this band. I don't have interest in returning to any of their albums, because they all sound the same to me. So, you know, essentially AC/DC, but just less catchy and less iconic to me. So there you go. I'm gonna give this album an 8 out of 10. I'm gonna leave this band on a good note. So there you go. This is a good band, but I just don't have interest in reviewing their albums, because they all sound the same to me. It just all sounds like fucking fuzz to me. Good album, but I just don't have any interest in them. You know, it's kind of like they're essentially jazz to me. It's good, it's a great genre, but I don't fucking care about it. So that's essentially what they are. King Gizzard is jazz to me. Good, it's good, but I don't give a shit. So there you go. That's probably the best way I can describe it. No more King Gizzard. Bye guys and peace.